Patrick 与中国缘分颇深。2016年，他第一次来到中国，先后在泉州、广州和北京的高中及俱乐部任职。30年来，他先后在加利福尼亚州的高中担任六项体育运动主教练，从业经验丰富。目前，他担任北京野蛮人橄榄球俱乐部的防守组教练。
I moved to Beijing, discovered the Beijing Barbarians, or they discovered me.And it's been amazing, just an amazing experience. Guangzhou Apaches are very good, but the Beijing Barbarians are a bigger, stronger, faster team.
在个人能力和潜力方面 ，Patrick 认为中美两国的运动员几乎没有差异。
Believe it or not, the ability, size and speed, and the ability are second, maybe third.I always tell my athletes, you have to have brains and heart and spirit. That's number one.
Patrick 一头银发，球员们都会亲切地叫他老头。他是球队的灵魂，总是能让技术特点不同的球员们都能在赛场上找到归属感。
所以我觉得 Patrick 不光是在专业程度上非常好，我觉得在国内现在的这么一个阶段。基本上每个城市都有业余球队，这么一个情况下，每个球队其实如果有拍摄这样的教练，对球队的帮助就非常非常大。而我觉得让我受益最多的是，就是拍摄让我们感受到那种这个运动真正的那种团结性，还有那种激情，让每个人都感觉自己在这个球队，在这个位置是被需要的。
Patrick 已年过六旬，根据规定，他不能在中国继续申请工作签证，他将在八月底离开中国。尽管如此，他将仍会在线上对中国球员进行辅导，制定训练计划，并让队员拍摄视频。
Yeah, well, I don't have a choice. I have to leave China. My visa expires. It just breaks my heart. But these are men, very smart, most.Very self-motivated, so they don't really need me. They're going to be good, and I will still have much contact, you know, on Zoom and WeChat.
对 Patrick 来说，近五年的中国生活让他感动与不舍。他在美国没有组建家庭，也没有孩子，他难以忘记中国的这群兄弟姐妹。
My mind is prepared.But my heart is not prepared to leave. And it's not just leaving this team. I mean, I have Chinese friends, you know, in three different places, particularly Chuanzhou and Fujian. They're like brothers and sisters to me. And these Guangzhou Apaches, and now particularly the Beijing Barbarians, I mean, these guys are like nephews or...long lost sons to me, and they have just embraced me. These guys I will never forget. Not easy.
Patrick 与他的中国朋友们有一个约定，以后一定会再回到中国，继续和这帮大孩子们一起训练，一起生活。